This video may contain the following: flashing images, violent bike battles, and scenes of horror.
Voyage 700 km au sud de Bordeaux.
Trompe qu'on le toll bridge. Ferly à la 46 hectare in 6. Itis VTI. Ouest de Bordeaux, des mesures et one depth of nature.
So I had arrived at Rainbow, where former world records have been held, where so many stories have been told. Walking around this prehistoric looking lake, where monsters lived in a true natural harmony, described as a Jurassic Park for carp. Where tactics used were incredible, float fishing on a totally different scale. Every swim with its own story to tell.
Peg 19. The Royal Box.
Where anglers from around the world had travelled to fish.
That's the island. Alan's out there at the minute.
This is my rainbow story.
Day one.
Right. First time out in the boat, peg 16, rainbow. There it is there. Looking forward to this. Right, so I'm out in the woodwork of peg 16. That there is the channel, right there.
That's where the swim is. So the swim is right back there. I mean, look at all this woodwork. Got all this.
Pool's on the right hand side in the woodwork. There's pool there. Fishing out in amongst all this. I'm going to go and have a look at a few spots now. So yeah, I mean, look at that sort of terrain, is unreal. You've got all these little dot islands here, here, here. Mental. That's the island up through there. Look at all that. No doubt Paul's going to have one here. Yeah. So there's actually two channels that run through here. There's another one that runs sort of through there. So there's another channel just the other side here. Just where Paul's going now. So we're going around to my bit now. Obviously still in the woodland bit. Paul's discussing with the guys next door where the boundary is and whatnot. He knows so much about this place, does Paul? Honestly, he's caught loads of fish out of here, so couldn't be at Rainbow with a better person, really. I still can't actually grip that I'm here. It's unbelievable. It's just the maddest place ever, and the way people fish it as well is just savage, absolutely savage. So I'm quite lucky. I'm on the left hand side of 16, and it's not, well, it's nowhere near as bad as what the right hand side is due to snag wise, but We're going around to the famous Brazilian tree, which some of you rainbow fishing peoples have obviously heard of the Brazilian tree. Even guys that don't fish rainbow have heard of it. It's done a lot of good fish. Fingers crossed it does Lockie's Common for me. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? So yeah, getting around there. Gonna go and have a look at this Brazilian tree, like I said. There's a couple of nice spots on the left hand side. Paul's telling me it's done in plenty of fish in the past as well. So yeah, let's get on round there and have a look at the Brazilian. Here we are. Brazilian tree. So I'm gonna have a nice little lead round here. See what's about. There's a tiny little fizzer which has come up just on the point of the tree here. Paul's gonna show me some spots that have obviously done him some whackers in the past. We've got peg 17 over there, Briggsy's in 18. So it might be a bit of a result for me, because I think whoever books 18 gets 17 or vice versa, and I'm sure he's going to go in 18, so that'll obviously free up all this area with no lines in it. So let's go and have a little mosey about on this bad boy.
There he is. There's a rainbow virgin just popped his cherry. He's, look at him, all excitable, shaking like a leaf. Is it a gripper? Is it a gripper? Let's hope so. This is off the Brazilian. The old faithful tigers and them. soon as the sun hits the corner of the island, she's away. Every morning. Let's just hope this is luck. Giving him a little bit of a run around to start with. Come on, Lee. Is that a face of panic? Or is it a face of, I got more phone screens? Oh, she looks alright, she looks alright. It's not a monster, but it's a bloody nice fish. Yeah. There she goes. That's the first one in the net. Is that a smile? Well done, mate.
First night on Rainbow. And I've bagged myself one. Unbelievable. Not just one, a proper nice one. So I'm absolutely buzzing about this. Quite an incredible looking creature. Gorgeous looking thing. Little bit of a monster. Easy girl. But look at this thing. Absolutely stunning. Look at that. What an incredible looking creature. 49 pound 15 ounces. What a beast.
Well, into another fish. Always gone very close in. Oh dear. Get him away from that tree. He's away from that tree, he's all yours. Over towards the left hand bank. A few rod lengths off of it. Nice little patch. Always does a few fish.
This has made the trip already. Absolutely buzzing. What a cod, yes!
He's got a good one. Happy days.
Jesus, believe it. Well, no sooner, than I put that 49 pounder back. Left hand rod goes, just bending round. Thought it was in the wind. Thought it was just the wind sort of bending it. Had another close inspection at it. And then I could tell that there was yet another one of these beautiful rainbow cod on the end. The fight was amazing, absolutely amazing. Proper buzz, well chuffed. For this one, another common, at 40, 41.12, was it Paul?
41, it was, 12? Yeah, 41.12.
Like 41.12, look at that. Absolutely buzzing. What a gorgeous looking creature from the mighty rainbow peg 16. Well chuffed, yes!
free.
Now, of course, people ask me all the time. They say to me, what is the secret to success?
Well, for fish number three,
the first rule is trust yourself.
45 pounds.
But what is most important is that you have to dig deep down. Dig deep down and ask yourselves, who do you want to be? Not what, but who. And I'm talking about not what your parents and teachers want you to be, but you. I'm talking about figuring out for yourselves what makes you happy, no matter how crazy it may sound to the people. So rule number one is, of course, trust yourself no matter how or what anyone else thinks. And of course, rule number two is break the rules. We have so many rules in life about everything. I say break the rules, not the law, but break the rules. It is impossible to be a maverick or a true original if you're too well behaved and don't want to break the rules. You have to think outside the box. That's what I believe, after all. What is the point of being on this earth? All you want to do is be liked by everyone and avoid trouble. The only way that I ever got any place was by breaking some of the rules. Which of course brings me to rule number three. Don't be afraid to fail. Anything I've ever attempted, I was always willing to fail. You can't always win, but don't be afraid of making decisions. You can't be paralyzed by fear or failure, or you will never push yourself. You keep pushing because you believe in yourself and in your vision, and you know that it is the right thing to do, and success will come. So don't be afraid to fail. Which brings me to rule number four, which is don't listen to the naysayers. I mean, how many times have you heard that you can't do this and you can't do that and it has never been done before? As a matter of fact, I love it when someone says that no one has ever done this before, because then when I do it, that means that I'm the first one that has done it. So pay no attention to the people that say it can't be done. I always listen to myself and said, yes, you can.
Look at that. Fish number three at 45 pound, 14 ounces. What a stunning looking creature. Oh, buzzing, absolutely pristine, gorgeous looking thing. Caught on a couple of tiger nuts, some of the bait tech chili emp, and I won't tell you exactly what tigers they are, but I'm sure they'll be soon to be hitting the shops sometime in the future. What a gorgeous looking monster, eh? Unbelievable. Buzzing, 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 buzzing. Yes!
Right, well, I'm at the halfway point now. Can't actually believe it's been a week already. Absolutely mental. It's just flown by. Quite incredible, really. But that's 3:40s I've had now. So, yeah, we come here for the big ones. We come here for the real whackers. Don't get me wrong. I'm grateful as hell to be catching 3:40s from the mighty rainbow, you know. It's an absolute incredible place to be, and every fish is a special one, no doubt about it. But we do come here for them whackers, that's for sure. And oh, I'd so love to to even see one on the bank, let alone catch one. But you're not going to catch them if you're not ear fishing for them. So that's exactly what I'm doing, ear fishing for them. And yeah, we've had 5 fish altogether. Paul's had 2. He had a 38 last night and a 31 as well. So he's getting amongst them now on the right hand side. This left hand side, it's been a bit of a struggle for people apparently in the last X amount of weeks, but I'm quite lucky because Paul knows this place like the back of his hand. He knows where the fish and where he's had big hits from and where he's had big ones from as well. Believe me, he's caught a fair few of them out of it, that's for sure. So yeah, at the halfway point, and ducks are doing my nutting. Briggsy's over there, they're doing his nutting as well, wiping out his banker rod. I got wiped out this morning by trailing bream, would you believe, carrying a 2-ounce lead. Quite what that was doing hanging out of him, I don't know. I think someone was fishing for him. Yeah, these ducks just will not give up in the swim, fighting. What, fight over there, you know, just fight, you know, where none of us are fishing. I don't quite understand why they feel the need to take off and fight around by the rods. Halfway point, I say it's gone very quickly. I am missing the missus and kids massively, no doubt about that. Yeah, so, fingers crossed, there's a big one in the air sometime soon. That would be nice because that is what we're here for.
He's in.
There he is out in the channel, playing one. Nice, in the net. Here he comes. Back from that channel bite. Hello mate, alright?
Hello, I'm fine.
I don't know if he's still got it in the net or not. Any joy?
I'm joy here. My English is not so good.
Right, okay. Are you in 14, are you?
Yes, yeah. Yes. And he caught something?
Just had one, yeah.
Yeah, my friend.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's a good one?
No, I'm not too sure. I don't know if he's brought it back or not. This big fish angler tends to put them back. How was it? Only a small one. So he's put it back.
And you catch?
I had some last week, yeah.
Day 8.
Right, there's me rig. Oh no, look at that. How mental is that? But that's already caught me a 41 pounder, so that's what I'm using. Some of them S4 XS's in size 2. I've sharpened them up, so it's absolutely razor point sharp, that is. Little bag of salt, which is that one is a halibut salt, I think it is. So yeah, just giving that a little whirl. Onto a lead clip system, 7-ounce lead. And that goes up to that poly ball there, which's also got a lead on it. Using that leadless leader. I've got about 6 or 7 foot leadless leader on there. And that is going out, right where that marker is there. So not too far from the bank. As you can see, there's the swim over there. Like I say, it's done me a bite, but that was nearly a week ago. It was actually a week ago that was. So yeah, hopefully they come back this Sunday. Let's hope so. Right, well, we're just getting ready for
a storm apparently that's brewing in the background. It's going to hit us in a couple of hours' time, I think. So just getting the rods ready for this storm. I spoke to Pascal earlier on and he said when the sky goes white like this, it's not too far away. So yeah, as you can see, look, it's whiter than anything really. Don't know what that is. Perhaps that's a storm bug. That mean looking thing. Oh God. I'll sleep with that at night, would you? Savage. Yeah, mean storm bug. So yeah, just getting ready. I've only got the Brazilian rod to put out next. Paul's doing his rod at the moment up at the channel. So yeah, this is the scene. At Rainbow on Monday, I believe it is, second week. Sort of lose the time of day or what days they are when you're on the bank for so long. Well, I do anyway, I don't know about anyone else. I'm sure half of these guys are used to it. Old Briggsy's over there, so I'm sure he's used to it. He's just managed to bag himself an extra week on the island. Lucky git. So yeah, happy days. So that's the scene. The calm before the storm. Just got a rod to put out there. The old Brazilian. So yeah, people get mistaken with that one. Thinking that one's the Brazilian. It's not. It's, oh no. Even though I've been mistaken, people mistake that one for the Brazilian when actually it's that one, that long one there. So yeah, if you ever do come here, peg 16, that's not the Brazilian, that one is. Right, let's get some bait sorted.
Well, I was going to redo the rods, but it's a little bit blowy. There's no way I'm getting in that boat. No way.
There goes Paul in this absolute savage wind. Good luck to him, I'm telling you, because this wind is unbelievable. And he's hooked one right up in that channel. How he's even keeping that boat straight is beyond me. Oh no, he's lost it. See the rod twang then. No. I think he's still got it. He's looking up at the channel now. I don't know. I'm sure I see the rod ooped over. There he is. Oh, it looks like he's still got it on. This wind is mental. It must be mad out there. Absolutely mad. Proper extreme rainbow fishing. Oh. Giving him the right run around the middle. In so you can sort of get a perspective of how windy it actually is out there, because it is windy. Reaching for the net. Salmon swoop.
What a legend.
Don't do this to me. Don't do this to me. Please. Oh.
We'll be right back.
Extreme fishing! Oh. Oh, I've got the driest mouth ever. Jesus. Oh. Did you get me camera, Paul? No!
Them moments.
Oh, I'm in absolute pain. Not had a bite the whole of this week, and then the rod that I put out 3 days ago, just off of the Brazilian, I found, well, I didn't find it. There's a bar out there that Paul told me about. But what I did find on the bar is there's a foot or so hump right on the end of it, which doesn't come up on the echo sounder. It only comes up if you sort of led around with a rod, or reeling the rod tip to the water's edge sort of thing, and leading around there, and found this hump for you. That's the winner, that is. And wind's obviously kicked up, and yeah, rod's gone. I don't know what the video glasses has caught, but it snapped 30 pound unleaded leader as a hook link. Snapped it. Now, obviously there was a tail rubber over that, which I've taken off. Yeah, that is just snapped it. First proper one lost at Rainbow, that. Ugh.
Day 13.
Yeah, I think so, mate. Cheers, bud.
Oh. You happy?
I am happy as can be.
On the Friday of the second part of the week, lost that monster yesterday, a little bit gutted by that, but this definitely makes up for it. I know it's not a monster, but probably my last rainbow carp of this trip. Just buzzing, absolutely buzzing. I can't believe I've been lucky enough to bag yet another rainbow beauty at 39.5 pound. Another common. Cheers, bud. Yeah, go on. 39.5 pound. What a stunning looking creature. Oh, so made up, absolutely amazing. Thanks to the good man that is Paul Hudson for bringing me here and letting me catch some of these finest looking creatures. Oh, absolutely buzzing my tits off, I can't believe it. Wicked. Yes.
Ooh, oh, I feel so alive. Oh, I feel so alive.
Right, well, it's my last day on this magical place that is Rainbow. It's quite hard to put into words, really, how special this place is. It is just, oh, it's just an amazing place, really is amazing. Obviously been here for 2 weeks. It's my last day and I'm gutted to go, you know. I've never ever done 2 weeks on the bank. And I think the longest I've ever done is about 10 days. And by them 10 days, I wanted to go home, you know. I had the hump, and although I'd caught fish and everything like that, and I'd caught some really magical fish, it was too long. It was too long away from the missus, the kids, and I just couldn't wait to get home, really. This place, don't get me wrong, I've missed the missus and the kids massively, but I don't want to go, you know. If I could bring the missus and the kids out here, I'd be in seventh heaven, no doubt about it. It truly is such a special place, it's unbelievable, and I'm so lucky to have that opportunity to be here. Oh, it's just incredible. This is my daily routine, walk round to the clubhouse, which would be my last time. So yeah, just making my way past my left hand rod here, which done me a bite on the first morning here. Sort of Paul said to me, you know, now that you've had a fish off of that, that's gonna do you a lot more fish. He's done in multiple catches in the past. It's just down here, there's me poly ball there. Just show you, look. There's me poly ball. Right there, look. So I've got two leads on that, so I'm probably fishing somewhere around sort of here, really, from it. And yeah, done me a 41 pounder first morning. Happy as Larry. Could have done me more fish, but you know, it's one of them. Lucky enough to catch one off of it, I suppose. So yeah, just walking past the Brazilian out there. That's done me two fish, which has been great. Been breamed out on it, which hasn't been great. But yeah, I can't thank Paul enough for giving me the opportunity to come out here and fish with him. He's fished this place loads. In about the last 10 years he's been coming up here 3 or 4 times a year, so I can't say thanks mate, honestly I've been absolutely buzzing from the minute we loaded the car back at home to this day now until the minute we leave tomorrow morning. I think what else makes this place so special is the people that are here. People that fish here, you know, from all around the world, everyone's just so lovely here. It's great. There's such a great buzz about the place. It's truly incredible. I just can't, like I say, put into words how special this place really is. I don't know whether it's the whackers that live in here, or whether it's just the people that are here, or the lake itself. It's just there's nowhere else in the world that I think you can go to and have what you have here. I really don't. And we're coming up to a peg
18 now. So it's my daily routine and my daily chat. You might know these two that are here at the moment. Hello mate, all right? Don't mind the camera there. I'm trying to reminisce on every memory possible. God, I've got the last day blues. Yeah, massively. Yeah. It's so horrible that 2 weeks have gone so quickly like that. Yeah, but you had a couple of good ones, didn't you?
I've had four good ones now.
Have you? Four?
Last three fish have all been 60 pound commons.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, I've just
got
that one
there.
Another
six,
one
there. 61 too. Yes. It's the rain to stop, yeah.
Oh, magical. Oh, brilliant. Well, I might get to catch some of that on camera then. We'll actually get first rainbow whacker on the camera, which would be nice. Amazing, that's great. And,
56 mirror in the morning.
Yeah.
60 in the corner went blocks here.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've seen that, you're having that tussle yesterday.
No, yeah, I didn't.
God,
no.
What a job. Yeah. Half Joe was up the shops.
Yeah.
Hello.
What?
Brilliant.
No.
I went shop with Julie. I went with Paul.
Yeah.
I went shop with Paul. And Julie and I came back.
Yeah.
I said to Julie, I think she had a fish because the boat was sitting here.
Amazing. Just sat here chatting to Steve and Joan. And look, Joan's rod's gone. Amazing.
Steve,
Briggs and Joe. It's like
a dynamic
trip duo. Goes
all
that
amazing. Well done, Joe. Oh, brilliant. Oh, brilliant. Oh, wow.
Well, it's been an absolutely amazing session. It's not over yet either. This is the third 60 pound common on the bounce, 61 pound 2 ounce. And on the old banker rod again. Unbelievable what's happening here. After a slow start, it's all kicked in, and well, Jones just had a 51 pound mirror as well, so it's all happening.
Just amazing, what a lovely couple. And that is also what makes Rainbow just such a special place. Lovely people like that, you know, there's not a lot of them, that's for sure, definitely. Wow, just amazing. So carrying on my walk to the clubhouse, this is the little koi pew pond, which Steve and Jane told me about. Their little home, not out at the moment, they tend to come out in the evenings all the time. So yeah, this is their little plot as such. Could you dream to have that in your back garden? Wicked. Hopefully I've captured some of the magical moments that I've had at Rainbow. And hopefully that's come across on camera, but I don't think you can truly capture how beautiful this place is until you come here. And it's not the easiest of places to get on anymore. It's everyone wants to be here, you know, and rightly so. Everyone wants to be here because it is that special.
just incredible, it really is. I mean, everywhere you look is just magical. It is truly, truly magical. What a place Pascal has here. What an incredible, incredible place it is. Hopefully you've enjoyed the show. Until next time, it's goodbye from me, but it's never the end, that's for sure.